Hi, I'm Jess, and this is Japan. So if you know your Japanese, you might know the word mirai. It means future, and that's a big theme of this museum here. So this is the Museum of Science, Emergent Science and Innovation, I believe. And yeah, it's all about science and connecting with the earth and how we have our place here on the earth and all that stuff, all wrapped into one. So they have a big focus on science communication. They raise their own science communicators here who then go on to other museums and other facilities around the country. And yeah, there's a lot to learn, there's a lot to see. We're not gonna be able to get all of it in one video, but we're really excited to show you what we can see today. So are you ready to see it? Let's go. Itadakimasu. Let's dig in. Hours, so this is stopped at the moment, but this exhibit is really cool. It kind of makes tangible what the internet, how the internet works. So each of these little towers is kind of like a router or a terminal where information is sent and received. And what they do here, so right here, they start with a computer. They use black and white balls to simulate the ones and zeros that make up binary code, and you shoot them out, and I guess they go around to the different locations, and it's meant to just kind of not symbolize, what's the word? It's meant to represent how the internet works in a more tangible way. So this is a really good way to show how that works. So this is not only just meant to represent how the internet works, but it's actually interactive. So you get to choose what your message is going to be, and you get to choose what the destination is, just like when you send an email or a picture to somebody using the internet. So it's actually, you know, from a user's perspective, you get to use the internet here in this exhibit. So it's really cool. I really enjoyed it. Okay, so we were just asked which of these cards is fake. So I'm gonna try to figure it out. I don't think any of them are fake, but... Oh, this one's fake. It's just like the surface of the... Wait, this isn't even real tatami. It's just... Is this printed? Wait, are these all fake? These are all fake. Oh my god, they're all fake. They're all fake. My eyes lie. My card for the game we're gonna play, Backward from the Future. So where global warming has stopped, clean water. For fish to be all the time. I wanna try this one. Linguistic diversity. See from my spot in the future, I'm coming back to the past, and I've seen what lies ahead, so hopefully that helps me. Alright, I gotta go with English. So something that's really interesting about this game, so it's teaching the concept of backcasting, so imagining your ideal future, and then working backwards to figure out how to get there, right? We're not forecasting just from where we are in the present, we're trying to see backwards. So it's really interesting how they've taken this concept and taught it in this very tangible way, and in like a gamified way. It's really cool, and it's one of the great things about this museum, I think. Check it out. Try it. It's hard. Looks like I got a letter, so I'm gonna read it. That's me. Oh, unfortunately, my world did not become reality. This is really interesting. So it's talking about the ideal world that you choose at the very beginning. So, my descendants say that they appreciate my efforts, but they're sorry that I didn't get to have my ideal world. That's really cool. I like the way that they've set this up. It's really, really interesting. So this is how far I got. Oh no, the global language became homogenized. I lost culture. Oh, this is really cool. So it actually tells you what happens here. So the one that I chose was to have linguistic diversity. So the things that happen to you, so I've got these minus ones that I've hit, right? So we've got, my minus one is uniform mother tongue education. So I guess they're just only teaching one language in the whole world. That's crazy. And then stronger assimilation policies, suppression of regional tongues. And then here's where I got a plus. Automatic voice translation speaking in minority languages, so that's good. So it not only does it kind of give you this grander concept of how backcasting works, but it actually gives you specific examples about these different ideal worlds that you choose. This is really cool. This really, I think, shows the way that Miraikan wants to communicate scientific concepts, but also connect it with how we actually think about our world. So that's really cool. This is really neat.
that's not how learning works. It actually has its own way of thinking. So it's learning from me, but it's also choosing what to do itself. So that's new for me. I thought I was just gonna do what I was doing, but that's totally different. That's not how intelligence works. It's really cool. Maybe I should learn from him. I feel like it's just coming out of the uncanny valley where... Oh my god, the way that she blinks sometimes, it looks really human. You look sleepy. Oh. It's crazy how far we've come from being able to create things like this. Actually, I thought it was just going to be purely educational, but it's actually kind of emotionally touching. It kind of made me feel like... Okay, so what we watch basically is called Birthday, and it's about kind of the evolution of the galaxy and solar system and the universe, basically. It makes you feel so small, but also so connected to everything. And it's just really good! So they've got different shows, they've got English guidance that you can listen to while you watch it, so you're not lost completely. But it's really good. I really recommend it. Go see it. Got really cool glasses too, so that's a plus.